In this video, I will show you how to make a load meter by using a mini digital DC 100 volt and 100 amperes meter with a few recycled parts, step by step. These are the female DC power supply socket, 9 volt battery connectors, wires with ring connectors, a switch, a mini DC voltage and ampere meter with its 100 amperes shunt, plus heavy-duty wires with 3 alligators in different color, some bolts, and a square aluminum box. This is that square box. A hole needs to be drilled here for fixing a switch. This larger rectangle hole is for installing the mini voltage and ampere meter. A hole here, which has been just drilled, is for installing a switch. Two more holes have been drilled on the back, which are for handy supportive. These are the wires, which have been connected, according to their functions, for DIY load meter. As showed previously, remove this heavy-duty wire with alligator in red collis by using the yellow wire instead. Incidentally speaking, there are two adjusters on the back of the mini meter for calibrating. Connecting the mini meter now. Thick wires are for the load's current. Thin wires are for the load's voltage and meter's power supply. This is the circuits diagram for DIY load meter. This is the meter's DC power socket. That is the DC 9 volt battery. The meter's DC power switch is here. The meter's shunt with DC 100 amperes capacity is here. The mini voltage and ampere meter is here and has been connected already. Thin red wire between the meter and switch is along here. This section wires which connected the switch to wires joints are along here. The wire in red color between battery's positive terminal and power socket's positive terminal is here in red color. Thin yellow wire from meter to joint of yellow alligator's wire is along here. Battery's terminal black wire jointed with the meter's black wire is along here. Also, the DC power socket's black wire jointed battery's black and meter's black wire together here. The other end of heavy-duty wire with a green alligator jointed with thick red wire from the meter and bolted here. the another end of heavy-duty wire with a black alligator, jointed with thick black wire from the meter, and bolted here at the bottom. The yellow wire with a smaller alligator is here, for the load-positive connection. The heavy-duty wire with a green alligator in color is for the load-current connection. The heavy-duty wire with a black alligator in color is for the power-negative connection. The thick red wire, which is for the load's current incoming meter, and connected in this way. The thick black wire, which is for the load's current outgoing from meter, and connected in that way. All things here need to be into and secured in an aluminum box. These wires combined in black color will be connected to the black side on the shunt after putting all things into the box. That black wire with yellow tape was the one mentioned earlier and secured by the black side on the shunt. The DC power switch and mini voltage and ampere meter. On the ends of shunt, 4 of rub rings have been installed, 2 on the top, 2 at the bottom. A shunt is between them. The rub rings were made by cutting bushes like the one here from recycled cars' components. So the shunt's any part will not contact with the box. There are 2 longer pieces of woods and 2 small woods which were customer made have been filled in those spaces just right to make sure all parts secured inside box. The meter's DC power socket is there and tied on the one of handy holes. A DC 9 volt battery is connected and the alligator's wires secured on the handy holes as well. Now is tightening 6 bolts to have the box secured. The DC 9 volt battery seats there nicely. And turned the DC power on, the mini voltage and ampere meter is working, then turned it off. This DIY load meter doesn't have to use 9 volt battery. It can be used the power socket here for range of DC 4 volt to DC 30 volt instead, such as 5 volt, 12 volt and 24 volt etc. By using car's wipe motor as a load, to use this SMPS as the DC power supply for the load. Switch DIY load meter on, and it is ready. As showed on the circuits diagram, the meter's yellow alligator connects to the DC power positive, which also needs to connect to the one of the load terminals. In this case, it is the load positive as well. Back to the circuits diagram, the meter's black alligator connects to the DC power negative. In this example, it cannot be seen as the load negative, it must not be confused. Switch the power on. DC 13.8 volt indicated by the mini meter for the load voltage. 0 ampere indicated by the meter, because the load has not been connected completely yet. Back to the circuits diagram again. The meter's green alligator connects to the one of the other load terminals. The white motor is turning. Volt indicated. Fluctuated 3 amperes indicated. And let it settle for a while. Now the meter indicated 13.7 volt, 1.2 amperes, and steady. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe if you have enjoyed the video. Your encouragement is my motivation.